What's up, guys? I'm Random Frank P. Back with another episode of Cool Tech Under $50 for June. The series where you show off some of the best tech you can buy under that price point. And spoiler, got some really great stuff this episode. See anything you like, I'll have it all listed for you in the description down below so you can check it out. And as always, shout out to last month's winners. I'll be in contact with you guys so you can claim your tech. But jumping right in, see that light behind me? Yeah, RGB light bulb, but it's also a speaker. Definitely not a pairing that would come to mind, but hey, add this to the list of cool shit that makes no sense. Either way, I'm sure you guys are gonna find it interesting. So when you plug it into a lamp and power it on, two things happen. First, it enables Bluetooth, so a comparative device. Then default, it turns on a bright white. Then from there, you can change it all up. These are available in the E26 or E27 fittings, I guess depending on where you live or your lamp thread. But it looks like a typical smart RGB light bulb out there, but it just has a speaker jammed right into the middle of it. Included is the RGB remote where you can pick up the colors, change up the lighting effects, has the basic color wave, a strobing effect, as well as a music visualizer that actually pulses along to the music. But you'll notice on the remote, the bottom's a bit different and you actually have multimedia controls here. Say it's paired to your phone, you want to just change the song or adjust the volume, just use the remote instead. Honestly, didn't expect that functionality. And how does it sound? Well, it sounds okay, you know, not amazing by any means. But if you're using this in like a desktop lamp like I am, odds are it'll be relatively close to you and at ear level. So it did sound better than I thought it would in that regard. And oddly enough, the bass like traveled down my lamp and would send pulses throughout my desktop. So that was pretty cool. But don't buy this to replace like desktop speakers. At the end of the day, I'm probably just gonna keep it a pure white color, but it is cool that it doubles as a speaker for only $13. Now, do you need this? No, but do you want this? Maybe. Could be a nice addition to your desk setup, and just to tell people, yeah, my light bulb is a speaker. Doesn't have to make sense to them. Now, next up is probably one of the all-time best gaming peripherals at the price, and that is the newly released Glorious PC Gaming Race Model O mouse. I put out my review 2 or so weeks ago. This is an incredible gaming mouse for just $50. You can buy this mouse in 4 different variants. It comes in a matte white version, a glossy white as well. You can kind of start to see the high gloss reflections, a glossy black option, which looks really sleek, then the matte black version, which will probably be the top seller. The differences here are both the matte versions are $49 at 67 grams a piece, and the glossy models are $59 at 68 grams a piece. So technically still fits the series if you go matte. And while that matte option is more popular, $10 cheaper and a gram lighter, I will say the glossy finish does provide a nice natural grip against your skin. But the weight is a big thing here with these mice. Having a gaming mouse at just 60 something grams is great for FPS games because it's so lightweight, your flicks can be quicker and more controlled. It is really something once you hold it. Integrated is also 3-zone RGB lighting that you can customize. It uses a 12,000 DPI optical gaming sensor, has a lightweight paracord for the cable, and their own G-skates for all you hyperglide lovers out there, really lets you glide nicely on your mouse pad. So you couple the lightweight shell, the feather-like cable, and those G-skates, and you have one crazy good option for a gaming mouse at this price. Trust me, out of every single gaming mouse I've ever reviewed, ever, this has hands down impressed me the most because you just simply can't beat this with all the features for just $50. This is an incredible mouse, and it's a Hall of Fame worthy nominee for the series. Next up is the KnobSound Little Bear 2-Way Switcher. What an adorable name. And this is extremely useful for a crowded desktop. Maybe you got like speakers, your headset or headphones, PCs, consoles, stuff like that. Now what this does allows you to plug in 3 different sources into this. So say you like your PC, your PS4, and a speaker output. Then the front, you plug in your headphones or a headset. Either way, it has to be a 3.5 millimeter connector here, which a lot of headsets are. And it also allows for 3 pole connection for headsets, so you can still use your mic. Breaking it all down, this means you no longer have to unplug or switch your audio outputs every single time you want to change sources. You keep your headset plugged into the one device here, and you can control which output it connects to with the touch of a button. On the device itself is a volume knob for controlling your headset audio. To the left is a button for selecting either source A or B for the output, depending on what it's plugged into. And to the right of that is a mute button. But it goes even further, because on the bottom you can see are 2 switches on the side. The left is the out option, meaning you can toggle between either going audio out to the headset or speakers if you use that middle output jack on the back. And the right switch is for either just muting just your audio or the headset mic audio as well. I probably did a poor job at explaining that. The Amazon listing has it more detailed if you want to check that out. But just lots of options here, all in this tiny device. And another bonus is that it's passive, meaning you don't even have to power this externally. So a great desktop gadget here for all those with a crowded setup, you know, helping you consolidate your audio and all your devices. This comes in at just $32 and goes to show you that, you know, cool little gadgets don't have to break the bank. Next up, I know you probably have nightmares just like I do about your phone dropping and cracking, but what if I told you you could take a hammer to your phone and it wouldn't break the device? Thought I was gonna do it, didn't you? Joke's on you. Look at that. Perfectly fine. Screen's all good. And this life-saving duo is from Dbrand. Both the Prism and the Grip are under $50 at 30 bucks a piece and legitimately makes this a killer addition to the series because the quality here is fantastic. And as you just saw, it's gonna protect your phone at all costs. The Prism screen protector comes with two protectors just in case you botch your first installation. And their installation dock greatly helps with, you know, aligning it to your phone. Definitely a nice touch here. You just essentially plug this into the bottom of your phone and then it's all lined up for you. Inside the box is an air bubble squeegee, a dust sticker, a microfiber cloth, and alcohol pads. I'm not gonna do like an install guide for you, they have that on their website already, but this was just super simple to do. Obviously you can check if these are available for your phone, but they do sell them for the new OnePlus phones, the Pixel phones, iPhones, I have this on my iPhone 10 here. And then just the end result if you installed it properly should look like this, a flawless cover. And again, just kinda, you know, to hit home one more time for you guys, I'm hitting my glass phone with a hammer, people. And there's no damage, no cracks, no broken screen. The screen held up and so did the Prism. And then going along with that is their Grip, which is the case for your phone. This is the newer V2 version. They made some solid improvements over the year. Taking a look on the inside is a nice microfiber lining so the back of your phone doesn't get scratched up when it's in here. You literally just pop the phone to the bottom, you press down on the top corners and you're set. Now the back of the Grip is kind of just like, you know, a plain blank cover, but if you really dig their skins, if you had a skin on your phone already, you could also pick up a skin for the Grip here. It can help you kind of maintain that look, you know? It gives you the option to customize, which is always something I'm a fan of. The Grip has more compatible devices from, again, you know, the Pixels, OnePlus, iPhones, even the Galaxy lineup. And in the end, your $1,000 phone is gonna be protected. It has the nice textured buttons, they're clickable, the proper cutouts, all the things you're gonna want in a case for just $30. Then wrapping this all up, I buy a lot of stuff for this series. You know, sometimes I'll get it in and it's really good, makes the cut. Sometimes it is just trash, garbage. Other times things completely blow me away. And that's the story with this smartwatch here. I had very low expectations for this, but when I got it in, it blew me away. This is a $35 fitness smartwatch that not only looks nice and minimal, but has more features than some watches quadruple the price. Has a heart rate monitor, measures your blood pressure, blood oxygen levels, it's a pedometer to count your steps and calories, time your workouts, monitors your sleep cycles, and is waterproof. And yes, you can receive calls and texts on here, check the weather, control your music over Bluetooth, and so on. But how you control everything is with the touch-sensitive bottom bezel of the screen here. All you have to do is just simply touch it to navigate through the menus. And you do a long press on the button to either, you know, enter that menu or start an exercise or initiate a sequence, just that kind of stuff. I said before you can customize, there are three different watch faces you can pick from, they're preset ones. And this does actually let you pick a photo from your phone to be the background and you could change up like what data is shown and where you want it, whether the top or the bottom. But honestly, I just like the stock face better. The actual screen being square isn't even really apparent until you make the custom watch face. That way when you pick a photo, you'll see the square outline. Might not be a big deal to some people, I just wasn't a big fan of that. So I'm gonna stick with the default screen, it just looks best. I think it blends in well with the rest of the watch. That's really the only downside. There's even also an app you can download that goes along with the fitness and the activity tracking, and it compiles all your data from your blood pressure, your heart rate and stuff, so you can just have it all saved on your phone. And the battery life on here has been stellar. I've been wearing it for 8 days straight and it's still got around like 25% left. So just a crazy good pickup for $35. If you ever wanted a smartwatch or an activity tracker, probably a must buy. You can also easily swap the bands, pick up new bands. This comes in three different colors as well. Crazy good. And guys, that'll wrap it up for this episode of Cool Tech Under $50 for June. Hope you enjoyed. Don't forget, I'll have everything you saw listed for you in the description down below in case you want to check it out. If you like this episode, give it a big thumbs up to show your support. Feel free to follow me on Twitter at RandomFrankP. And lastly, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. Well, I'm Random Frank P. Hope you enjoyed. Have a good day.